think we survived without a father. And, and quite a remarkable thing that why they picked. Because by somebody wanted to buy some land here, and so those two lots were surveyed in that period. Now, let's see. The cemetery. In going through the records, you find that there's a great number of children were buried in the Liberal cemetery, and you can understand that because there was no hospitals and no proper medical care, and so very often a child would have died, and be buried at Whitwater, and quite a number of them weren't even buried with the minister. It could just be one of the local farmers would bury that child there. And I think there were some 57 children actually buried in the Whitwater cemetery. Richard Tonsar Wilson was buried in the Whitwater cemetery, and his wife Rose, and of course, you'll recall that John William Adams and Susanna Adams that came out on the HMS Buffalo in 1836, they were also buried at Whitwater. So, Whitwater Cemetery has quite a significant place in our history. And it was only 2 years ago that the last person was buried in Whitwater, a chap from Snowtown, who had his forebears were buried at Whitwater, and he was a bachelor, and apparently he decided that he should be buried with his great grandparents, I think it is, and I couldn't forget the name. We were reaping hard on the hill, and we could see it that stuff. I shouldn't say very much about the blacksmith because I was associated with that with my grandfather, and you all know that he was a local blacksmith there and here. But I'll just give you a couple of side with regard to the blacksmith. So because of the location just up past that gateway, and Granny Hudson, that's my father's talking, Granny Hudson was walking across the yard with a pail of milk in her hand, like the milk. And my father, being a good slingshot, having one of those little rivets, from up the old water tank, he thought, well, here's a chance, and I'll see if I can hit him. And lo and behold, he did. So all what Granny Hudson had left was the handle, the left of the milk was gone. Nobody did it. And then my father also tells me the time when Wilson had the shop there, a big white horse. One New Year's Eve, all the boys from around here, my dad was in the bus there, they managed to get a couple of dogs on down the store, and they got the horse and they put all stripes around him, turning into a zebra. And Dad and his brothers had the window facing south of the sea. Across the Wilson to see what was going to happen next morning when Wilson came out to have a look and saw his horse. Dad reckoned he was quite unpleasant things that went on from what he said about those boys in Whitmore and doing to his white horse. But that was good clean fun. Good clean fun. They wouldn't do that these days, would they? Now, I ought to mention too about my father losing his finger when he was a lad. And he had a little water cart and it had four wheels. And down the back of the house there, I think we're all aware, was a fairly steep bank. So if all the kids of the town got together, they could get the cart up hill and then all sit on and ride it down the hill. You know, just like all the kids these days. And he hopped on, but the front wheel just, you know, twisted the turn, he had his finger over the side of it. The finger off. And he lost his finger going down the hill with using the cart, the water cart. That's about all I think I need to say about the old days. Now, just a few things that I remember as a kid, but a lot of you will remember when Dino's had the post office. I can still remember that. And I can still remember the old mail car. When it got burnt out just below the river before the bridge. Who can remember that old car still standing there, meant for quite a number of years down in the gully there where it got burnt out after it got on fire, the mail car? But anyone remember that? Bob, you should be able to remember. I can remember that.
Sure, my son.
Hey, you'll be able to remember that.
No, I don't remember that.
Oh, you should be able to. I can, because I'm a lot younger than all of you. And I remember Pell's having a mail run for years and years, and twice a week, a mail run. And we would just be able to ask kids, when we were going to school, we could get our bought lunch twice a week, if we ordered it in the baker's shop. Mr. Pell would bring it out and leave it in the shop down there, and we were allowed to go and get our bought lunch. And that was something that we really thought was absolutely marvellous, if you could have a bought dinner occasionally. Well, we never had it very often. Pretty seldom, but you know, that was just one of those things that, you know, I suppose happened, and a service to the community that was.
We hauled that train of Dino's.
She used to do it too, already.
Yes.
Yeah. So that was community effort. Yes. They just do that. Bring out all their lunches and put us out before a pasty. Yes. And a candy for a bun or something. And it was pretty cheap. But they did that for years and years and years, even when I was going to school. Back to the old hotel, I can remember when that was used, or some of the rooms were used for Red Cross. The old bar area of the hotel was used for Red Cross, and a lot of you remember that, all the Red Cross meeting shell down in there. And the old church floor up at the tennis court got a bit too dilapidated, I suppose. I shifted it down there. And it was our pizzas, wasn't it? Our pizzas lived down there. Bob, you should know.
Alan's father, wasn't it?
Alphix. Was it? Bill Higgs. I remember the floods, and I can remember the floods coming through and coming down through in between Lee's and what was Mrs. Toohey's. The flood coming down through there and across those paddocks.
That
doesn't happen there. Yeah, well, that's 50 years. But it doesn't happen these days. It sort of changed. And I can remember we had a greyhound dog after one flood, and there were that many rabbits. They all got washed out. There were rabbits down all over everywhere. The poor dogs, they chased them the first half a dozen, but then after that they just give up. Eating all the rabbits. But they certainly got the rabbits out of the river for a little while. It was quite amusing to see how the dogs weren't interested in the rabbits. Everybody's dog had to come down. Wilson's dog, Bob Wilson's dog, must have. Yeah.
Bob's dad came down with a horse and dray, took us kids on through the river here, down through there, and the water was lapping the bottom of the dray. He took us home
through the flood there. We haven't had that for a long time, have we?